Satsitananda Vigraha Anadira Dir Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam.
Okay, Hare Krishna Urugāya. Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Maybe not everybody knows you, so maybe you can introduce yourself, where you're from, where you serve now, how has been your journey?
Sure, okay, I'll try to keep it short.
Yeah.
So I'm Urugāya Das. I'm from Sydney, Australia. I joined in Sydney, Australia, mm-hmm. and then I was there like 3 years. Then I traveled 3 years with Pavanitai, who's now in Vrindavan, with Harinamananda, Vishnujan, these boys.
Oh, the Harinam party?
Yeah.
Okay, so throughout the world, not only Australia?
Not just Australia.
Okay.
Different places. Mm-hmm. I was all over the place, New York with Ram Roy and different places.
You were a brahmachari back
then? As a brahmachari, yeah.
Okay, cool.
6 years. And then I settled in Mayapur just before the end of 2019. Changed to white. Gumaj blessings for that. And anyway, I've been in Mayapur last 3 years. And main service we have online, like preaching online project called Chant Now. You can look it up, chantnow.com. It's really cool.
Okay, it's your YouTube channel or?
Yeah, it's got YouTube, so Instagram, Facebook. We have a website.
Chant?
Chant Now.
Okay.
Like Chant, Chant Now.
Chant Now.
Yeah. And devotees come, new bhaktis pretty much from all over the world, like through Sankirtan or through temples, and we just basically online cultivate them.
Cool.
It's a really nice project. And then the last 2 years, me and my wife, we started with my brothers. They're helping her three brothers. Mm-hmm. Food for Life, 3 times a week we're doing with Harinam Sankirtan in Mayapur.
In Mayapur.
In around the villages.
I heard
in
like it's very important to bring the whole Bengali community together so that they really appreciate and like
the devotees. Really
sometimes
cool.
We're like Westerners conquering Bengal.
Yeah. No, no, this is my favorite service. This Food for Life is really nice. But I don't have enough time to do it full on.
Mm-hmm.
We'd want to do it more, but this is a wonderful service.
Yeah. Great.
Yeah.
Nice you're doing it. Ambitious.
Yeah.
How did you meet Maharaj? And what did convince you that you say like, he's my guru?
First time I met Maharaj was so nice. I was maybe 3 months in Krishna consciousness.
So that was 5 years ago, 2000?
This would have been 2014.
Okay, wow.
Yeah.
6 years ago.
So I'd just been around for a very short time. And I was coming back, we were book distributing. I just came back and up the stairs to the ashram, Maharaj was just sitting on the top of the stairs, on the floor, no mat, just on his laptop, like super chill, no servants around him, just like really calm. And I was like a bhakta, I didn't really know, I was with one other brahmachari, he saw Maharaj, he like paid dandavats, and I was like, okay, I also paid dandavats. And Maharaj just like sit back, he was like so relaxed, he's like, how is Sankirtan, what's going on? Like, and I was like, wow, he's so... I'd met two other gurus before Maharaj, and I didn't know he was a spiritual master actually,
okay.
Because before, other times they had their servants, they had their like entourage, and it was kind of like a little bit hard to get close. Not really, but we got also mercy from them, but Maharaj was just so relaxed. So I asked the temple, can I have his darshan? Can I meet him? I told him I want to meet him. They said, yeah, we'll arrange for you.
Mm-hmm.
So the next day we went, I came back early from books, and they arranged for me to meet with Srila Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. I just remember going in the room and I remember telling him like, Maharaj, I'm like suffering so much. Like I believe in Krishna consciousness, like I'm convinced, but I'm not like happy here. It's really difficult for me. My mind is disturbed. I feel like leaving,
mm-hmm.
leaving this place. And he told me, don't leave. He said, go to Vrindavan.
Wow.
It's the first thing he told me, go to Vrindavan.
Wow.
And I remember speaking back and forth and just being like so inspired. The energy, the atmosphere, I was just like, wow, whatever he has, I want what he has. I was very, very inspired, touched in my heart. There was a connection straight away. And I came out of the room and I told the devotees, this is my guru. This is my spiritual master. And they were like, chup chup, you're a bacha, just relax, you know.
Yeah.
You should listen to other gurus, you should listen to everything. I was like, no, no, this is my guru. So then, anyway, we'll wait sometime. He came back 6 months later. And the whole time I was hearing his lectures and kirtans and... Yeah, I just knew he's my guru. I just knew straight away from the beginning. I didn't have any doubt. And I kind of listened to some other gurus and then when he came the next time, he was ready to give initiation, but temple wanted me to wait one more year, actually, 6 months later.
Okay.
So after 1 year, he gave initiation to me, yeah. So, but it was really nice. First meeting was very inspiring, yeah.
Touched him.
Yeah, straight away I was like, wow. There was no like fear or anything. He was just like so welcoming, like physically and energetically also. I was really, really touched. Yeah, and he took care of me so nicely, like all the way through. He was always very affectionate to me. Yeah.
Many said it's like Maharaj was very personal to us. Yeah. His disciple, like a father.
Yeah. Okay. Till I got married, then he was like, you're okay now.
That's fun.
Yeah.
Is there any special service that you did to Maharaj that really pleased him?
I think Maharaj, he always knew I'm like a useless guy to do anything for his body. Like, I'm not this kind of like servant type, actually. So he never really gave me this service. He always was telling me to preach. He was really happy that I'm distributing books, and he was really happy that I'm trying to encourage people to come to Krishna consciousness. And Maharaj told me to do this for my life. He said, you should preach for your whole life. This is what he wanted me to do, yeah. Not that I'm...
Can wear a t-shirt. Yeah. Tattoo.
Yeah.
Preach for my whole life.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
This was... I can't like do things for him like nicely and stuff like this. He'll smash me. I'm retarded. But yeah, for bringing people to Krishna consciousness, this was what he was inspiring me and encouraging me to do. Yeah.
And now looking back this year, is there anything that you... thing like you regret not doing, or that you missed not telling him, or is there something in your heart?
Not specifically. I mean, I really wanted to play mridanga for him one last time. Mm-hmm. And I didn't have the like courage or the opportunity to do that, unfortunately. That's kind of my only regret. I think, you know, just now when Maharaj was leaving, it was like I had this desire in my heart to be close to him. And so this morning when we came to the room, they didn't let us in, we were outside, there was too many people. So then I went home, I did puja for our deities, and then my brother Vrindavan, he messaged me like, yo, come. I'm like, bro, I'm in the middle of puja. He's like, come right now. So I really quickly just like finished drying, like bathing them, drying them, put them there, left them, ran, because we're like 200 meters away. I just like sprinted, and then I got there and there were all these ladies, and I was feeling shy, like to just like push through them, you know. And then one of the girls, my friend's wife, he said, no, go, you can go to the front. I said, okay. So I just like pushed through. Then Harinamananda, he just like grabbed my arm and pulled me to the front. And then Arjuna just like pushed me in the room.
You were in the room?
I was in the room. And Maharaj was there and all the devotees. And then I had like proper, like my heart was like completely satisfied with this darshan. And it was like all the time I like wanted to be close to him. And then Krishna just like give this final like satisfying desire. And then Jai Dwaita Chamachkama said, Prabhu, like, why are you here? And I was like, Maharaj, just darshan. He said, okay, take darshan and then go out. So I just like pay obeisances, so Maharaj one last time and go. So yeah, I don't have like so much regret or anything. Like, obviously maybe I never told him like about our food for life. I never like sat down and went through like chant now with him. I never like really showed him what I'm doing with my life now that I'm in the grass darshan. But I just feel like, you know, he prepared me. He's like happy with me. He knows what I'm doing like on a different level, you know. So I don't really have any regrets or anything like that. Just I would have wanted to play for him one time.
That's me.
Yeah.
Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
And in this time, like this last 6 months, that since we knew it's going to be intense now, is there any treasure that you take, like that you learned from this experience?
Oh, that's a really deep question. I think I would have to think about that for some time. I just know like when we got the news, we just like dropped everything and went with him. And the first time we saw Marge, he immediately grabbed me and my wife in we're in UK in Soho. He just like took us outside and sat us in the park like 45 minutes. He sat and just like speak with us and chat with us. Yeah, that was really sweet. Like straight away, as soon as he saw us, he said, hey, you guys come. And I really appreciated that, because obviously as time went on, more and more people became more difficult to see with him. But some treasure, I just feel like Maharaj, he prepared me for like the last 3 years. He was like preparing me for this relationship with him, where it's like, whether he's physically here or not, obviously like we're deprived of being able to see him and speak to him like this on this physical level. I just really feel like he prepared me in the sense like the relationship that I have with him is not like so much dependent on me like having to be there and touch him and hold him, because the last 3 years I didn't have so much interaction with him actually. But he made me strong in the sense like I'm seeing him like through like senior Vaishnavas or like some class that really like connect with the heart. I'm seeing this is my spiritual master like speaking to me. This is Guru Maharaj. He's like communicating in different situations. So in that sense, I really feel like my relationship deepened and grew kind of like in a broader perspective. So I'm so grateful to him that he like prepared me for my whole life actually, to like be connected to him, be connected to the service. Yeah, and what he said to me and spoke to me, this is like the vision of my life. He gave me everything from the beginning till now. He gave me like He gave me everything, so much, really, so much. And
it's amazing how he prepared. Yes, like it's a perfect organizer, isn't it? He's a good manager.
So yeah.
he prepared all of us, like the last things he wanted to tell us. He said, like, he did it, and even his ceremony, he prepared it, everything how it should be, and now we're here and we're just receiving all this gifts we have.
It's sad, like I feel sad for sure. It's like happy sad, you know.
Yeah.
This is like spiritual world also. They're like crying, you know, all the time. It's like happy sad, but. Yeah, I don't feel like anything lacking in my life. He gave me so much support. He gave me so much structure, like to this moment. You know, I feel supported on all sides. I feel like my life is completely best, and I can see it's His mercy, really. I feel like that in my heart. That is His mercy, yeah.
And now when we will part, like it just happened a few hours ago, four or five hours. And do you have any message you would like to tell our God family? That's like,
yeah, it's like another deep thing. It's like so like heavy too. I guess for God family, I would say, I don't know if I'm just like speculating, but I would say, like, you know, our spiritual master, he's not just like some guy that was born in Amsterdam that like came to Krishna consciousness and then he like did a bunch of service, and then he's like, it's so much more than that. Like, he's really representing like Krishna. He's the representative of Krishna. It's so much more than just like some human, you know what I mean? So I would just, I mean, who am I to say, but like that energy is accessible, you know. I was sitting in the kirtan just before, and it was pretty sunny, and then my brother Vrindavan, he goes, man, Marj need an umbrella. And I was like, what, Marj? And he's talking about the picture. Mm-hmm. And I was saying, man, this guy, he's like seeing spiritual master, because it is.
Yeah.
Guru Marj is there, but I didn't have that. So that was also like a lesson for me that, yeah, we can still access our spiritual master. So we should have no fear. We should have, so obviously we lament. And it's really mystical, because just yesterday, or like these days, I'm reading this pastime of Dhruva Maharaj, when he go back to the spiritual world. And when we were in Maharaj's house, like with the kirtan going when he was leaving, I was really remembering this pastime of like Dhruva Maharaj and how, like, you know, the Vimana comes, and I was just thinking, wow, what must be happening on this level, you know?
Interesting.
I was really feeling like, and actually after that, I quickly went home. After everything kind of settled, I went home because I had to finish the puja. And I just felt like Marge's presence, actually. I know he left, but I just, like, when I stepped into my apartment, I feel like Marge was there, and I like tripped out for a second. I was like, whoa. It was just like my mind, you know, but I really felt like Guru Marge there, you know. For me, I really feel like, and maybe this is also a message for the God family, like, it's not, okay, like, again, we're deprived of the association, but it's not like so different, actually. We keep going, the relationship is there, everything's there.
Some say it's like, now it's not anymore bound by the body.
Yeah.
Now it can be more present for us.
Yeah, and I feel relieved actually for him.
Yeah.
I feel like happy. So happy sad. This is our philosophy.
Yeah, you were telling us you have some dreams, and I need to tell you before you start that I heard like at least 20 of them overdoing, but around 20 devotees have been dreaming very intensely about Maharaj the last day. So
yeah.
I'm very excited to hear your dream.
No, it's just it was maybe 4 or 5 nights ago, like just before they start shutting the door for Maharaj. We were all in the apartment making kirtan. Like, I don't know who was singing, I don't remember, but
that was part of the dream that you were
we were making kirtan in my dream. Uh-huh. And then Maharaj came out of the room. He went to the kitchen and got like a pot of like khichdi or something, and then start like taking, scooping out from the khichdi, eating, and then dancing in the kirtan.
Wow.
Yeah, and then I woke up. Yeah. So I was like, this is our Guru Maharaj, you know. Body is finished, but he's going. Yeah.
He's still going. He's still partying on.
Yeah. And experience.
I think that's the best ending words. We are happy, sad.
Happy, sad.
Special moment. Thank you so much for sharing.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.